I am LMA, and I'm here to do a quick review of the JBL EON208P. Now, if you want to see all the specs and everything else, you can just look this thing up online and you'll have a complete list of specs. I want to talk a little bit more about usability. What would something like this system be used for? So I originally bought this system because we were doing karaoke. We were doing it in our home, we were doing it in some friends' homes, and we just wanted something, this sounded really good. We wanted to be able to plug in some microphones, possibly more than one microphone. Now, before this system, we were using a Gemini 15-inch two-way speaker, which had Bluetooth, and it had, we could plug in some microphones. And I mean, it worked for a while until it didn't. But it just, it still, there were a couple things that we didn't necessarily like about it. Quality of sound was one of them. So we decided to go with the JBL. I've heard this in the Guitar Center. They had it set up in the parking lot like years ago, or a couple years, I guess. And right in front of the store, and I was really impressed with how it sounded. So I went ahead and purchased this. Now what you get with this system, okay, you get the main mixer board, which is also the amplifier, and you have 2 8-inch two-way loudspeakers, satellite speakers, whatever you want to call them. So these are passive speakers. These speakers are not amplified. You don't have to plug power into them. You just simply plug the audio cable into the back of each speaker from the unit, okay? So they are wired up. Now with the system itself, you get two speakers, you get the mixer board here, you get an AKG microphone, and you also get, of course, the microphone cable, and you get the power cord to plug this in. You get a little pouch with the microphone, a little clip where you can put it on a mic stand. It doesn't come with the stand itself, but you can screw it onto the top of the stand. And so yeah, that's pretty much what you get. Now, let me show you the backs of these speakers here. So as you can see, you have one input here, which of course will come from the main unit here. So as you can see on the back, you have where you plug in the power on off switch, and then you have your outputs, left and right speaker output. Now, something really cool about this is it also has a compartment on the back where you can store your microphones. Now, this Shure SM58 didn't come with the system, though this is the one I use most of the time. However, the mic that did come with the system, hopefully nothing falls out of there, is this one here, the AKG. And this one does have an on-off switch, which I actually kind of like the on-off switch. Especially when you're doing karaoke and you're handing mics and you're setting them down, you can turn it off so you don't get feedback if somebody sets it in front of a speaker or something like that. So pretty cool. And this mic actually sounds really well. It actually picks up a little bit louder than the Shure mic, which I wouldn't have thought, you know, but it does. It does really well. However, you do get a little bit more feedback with this mic than you do with the Shure mic. So we use this most of the time if we're going to do some duets. We may pull out this mic and plug it up too. Again, the Shure did not come with the system. The system comes with the AKG. Now this is a metal body. I mean, it feels like a rugged microphone. Pretty nice. Now,
all right, so let's talk about some of the settings and the inputs and stuff like that, okay? So you saw on the back, it just had the power input and then also the speaker outputs you can see here. So, quick look here, you can see this is a two-way speaker. You have your tweeter up there, you have an 8-inch woofer here. And they sound really nice. They sound excellent, actually. We'll get into that in a minute. Okay, so why did I choose this system? First of all, these speakers actually clip onto this main unit, and I mean it's an easy way to carry everything around. It's a nice compact unit. I really liked it for that. And also, I like the idea that it has reverb. So it has a total of, what, 8 channels, Four of them are either used for line or mic. It does have a button here, so if you're using mic, you can push it in. If you're using something from a mixer or something, you know, a line in, you want to make sure that button is pushed out so you don't damage anything. It has reverb on and off on these four channels, so you could have four mics plugged up here, each individually adjusted with the volume. They could each have a different amount of reverb. You can adjust the bass and the treble on each of the mics. So that's really cool. I really like that. It also has phantom power. So if you want to use a mod, although I haven't had success yet with a condenser mic on this because they pick up so much, you get a lot of reverb, but you know, that's down the road. I would like to figure that out. But anyway, it does have phantom if you want to use something like that. Another cool feature about this is it has Bluetooth pairing. So we just pretty much hook up our iPad. So pretty cool. We use a music stand just to set the iPad on. So you have the words and everything right there when you're doing karaoke. Very cool. Now, when you're using Bluetooth, there is no volume control for Bluetooth. This is master volume, which controls everything. But the Bluetooth does not have a volume, but that's, if you're using a Bluetooth device, most likely it's a phone or an iPad, and you can just turn down the volume a bit on the phone or the iPad itself, and that adjusts the volume in here. Turn it down. We usually leave it, about 3/4 volume on the iPad, and then we can put the mic at about 3/4, maybe a little bit higher, depending on, you know, who's singing. I'm pretty loud, so I can turn it down, but others may have to have it a little bit louder. Anyway, so yeah, and then you have channels 5, 6, 7, 8. You can see the inputs here. They each have volume controls. That's all the control those two channels have. So that would probably be a mixed channel that you stick in there anyway. Maybe a CD player or whatever you want to do, MP3 player. So of course these are stereo channels. And then you have. All right, these are the things that I really like about this, okay? You do have a headphone out, okay? I tried this. I don't really like it, although it works great. There's nothing wrong with the way it works. But when you're singing live, you know, and you have headphones on, there's just something about it, for me anyway, that I kind of get a little nasally, right? So I would rather have a monitor. And it doesn't come with a monitor. It comes with these two speakers and this. However, we did purchase an Alto 8-inch monitor, and the monitor will have to be powered, right? So it'll have to be a self-amplified speaker, because this is a passive output here. It's not gonna send an amplified signal out of this, right? So you'll need to have a powered monitor. And I tell you what, this monitor here is what, $130, and it works really, really well. Now this volume is independent from this one. So you could literally have this volume turned all the way down, so no sound is coming out of these speakers, and then have your monitor volume turned up, and the only sound come out of the monitor. Now, I don't see that you would ever want to do that, but I just say that to let you know that this is completely independent. So if for some reason you need to have the monitor louder than the main system, you can do that. Now, there's also a subwoofer output, which is really cool. When you plug a subwoofer, now as it is right now, before we go into the subwoofer, let's just talk about the sound of these, right? And what JBL, I believe they were going after. So the sound is very flat. It's very good. When I say it's flat, I don't mean that's a bad thing. What I mean is it's not overly compensating for highs. It's not throwing out a bunch of bass, right? It's actually a flat sound. I mean, it sounds excellent. It's very balanced. That's the word I'm looking for. It's a very balanced, crisp, clear, pleasant sound to listen to. It's very, very nice. Some speakers that I've had in the past, for instance, I mean, the highs are just overwhelming. Now, don't get me wrong. If you crank this thing up, these highs will, they're pretty sharp. And they get pretty loud, but that's just because, I mean, but compared to the music, they're not overly loud. I should say that, right? And they're not real twingy or anything like that. They're clear and crisp. I mean, the sound quality is flat out amazing. Now, I know that, how should I say this? So I watched it, when I bought this, I was expecting a lot of bass, just because I listened to one of the promo videos for them, and you know, it says JBL nose bass. And while the bass is very balanced, the bass is nice, it doesn't create distortion in the vocals or anything like that, right? I mean, it's a very, very high quality sound. The bass in no way, shape, or form is gonna rattle you. It's not gonna rattle anything in your house. It's not gonna, you know, it's just, it's not thumping. It's not anything like that, right? But it does still sound incredible. So now we come to this port here, right? The subwoofer output. That also is not an amplified signal, which is good because if you hook a subwoofer to this, you wouldn't want it to have an amplified signal because it would take amplification away from these. So when you connect a subwoofer, actually what happens is you remove some of the need of the speakers for power, right? Because now it's not using that as a subwoofer too, or trying to anyway. And you can get a clearer, louder sound, I guess you should say. I mean, there's not a whole lot of difference. It is automatically crossed over. So you're getting the full sound here. When you plug a subwoofer into this here, it does cross over the system for you. It sends out a signal to the subwoofer and it crosses over those and it removes some bass from these two. So you do get a fuller sound. Now, the subwoofer I went with, I didn't buy this right away. I just actually just got this subwoofer a few days ago, and we have put it through its test, and it's great. It's not overly powerful by any means. The subwoofer, still, you're not going to feel it in your chest. You do feel it in the floor, and you do have things rattle in the house a little bit. And you walk outside, you can still hear the bass. But it's not going to completely rattle your chest. It's not going to overpower. It actually is a perfect fit. Now, if you're somebody who is just an absolute bass head and you're looking for crazy amounts of bass, which I used to be like that when I was younger, way more bass than music, right? Where you can't even really hear what the music is doing. Well, then that's the wrong sub for you. You know, go get something more powerful, a 15-inch, whatever, but that one will not cut it for you. However, if you're looking for a really full sound that just is just an incredible sound, it's really full, it's got deep bass where it'll rattle things, but it does not in any way, shape, or form overpower these speakers, then that sub is perfect. Now keep in mind, the signal going out to this sub, while it is not an amplified signal, it is still a variable signal, right? And it's in line with the main speakers, obviously. Otherwise, when you turn up the volume, you'd have to adjust the sub to get the volume. Makes sense. So I really crank that sub up all the way. I actually use a little bit of boost. I don't know what signal. I'll have to look on the back to see what signal I'm actually boosting. It might be around 70. I don't know. Yeah, and then it's perfect. Now, I'm going to be honest. If I turn off the boost, normally I don't like to use boost because boost sometimes creates distortion and stuff, but you got to, because it's not, I do like some bass, you know, I do like to, yeah. So, and it depends on the music, you know, some of my son's rap songs and stuff is way more bass than in, say, some of the stuff I listen to. So anyway, this is the complete system that we use, and it is a super, super nice system. So you got the JBL 208P, well, EON 208P, and I'll go ahead and put that together for you in a minute. And then we supplemented with the Behringer 12-inch powered sub, and also the ALTO 8-inch powered monitor / PA speaker. So yeah, excellent. Excellent sound. Now the ALTO is a decent sounding speaker too. But as far as just quality of sound, I believe the ALTO actually may have a little bit more highs, but the quality of sound, comparing them, I mean, the JBLs are just, I mean, they're better quality sound for sure. So there it is. how loud does this go? Okay. So when we're doing karaoke, we have it cranked quite a bit, you know, the master volume. All right. So here's the red dot is what indicates. So that's completely off. That would be completely up. We probably leave it at about, you know, almost 3/4. Sometimes we'll go a little more. We leave and the volume on the iPad at about 3/4. If we had that all the way up, it gets much louder. So if you're doing karaoke, the system isn't necessarily going to be as loud as if you're just playing music. Because if you're just playing music, you could crank the iPad all the way up. You don't have to worry about keeping the music down a little bit to make sure you have plenty of vocals. And when I say plenty of vocals, I mean where you can actually hear the vocals over the music, you know. I mean, it's great. I am very, very, very pleased with the system. It's incredible. We've used it several times now, and it's just, I mean, it sounds wonderful. I highly recommend, though it's not necessary, I highly recommend the sub. Sub, I think, was $299. So, yeah, I mean, that's $300. I mean, $300 is a lot of money. It is for me, anyway. But it was worth it. It was worth it. And there's no need to go out, in my personal opinion, spend $1,000 on a sub for this system. Okay, so another thing that I really like about this system is that it is expandable depending on what you have as your other components, right? So you just saw where that sub. Now, on the back of this sub, let me show you here. So on the back of this sub, you can see where there's, well, of course, there's actually two inputs and two outputs. Now you got a through also. So you have an input, a through, and an output. So I could actually chain link multiple subs on this, right? Now, I mean, technically, according to the instructions of the sub, I could actually put regular speakers on this too, but I wouldn't want to do that because the signal that's going to be coming out of the mixer board, the JBL, is just a sub signal. So it wouldn't make much sense to try to chain in some regular speakers with the sub because you're only going to get a sub signal. But if I wanted to add another sub, I could definitely do that. So the system can grow with me, I guess is what I'm saying. Same thing with, you know, the monitors. If I wanted to, per se, you know, say, now the full signal is coming out into these monitors. It's not necessarily, you know, crossed over for the sub and stuff. It is a full signal. So I could link a bunch of these monitors and use one of them to face the singer or, you know, the performer, and I could turn some others, you know, the other way. And what I could do to, I could adjust volume independently on these speakers. And really what I could do is, if I want the forward facing speakers to be louder than the one that's being used as a monitor, all I have to do is adjust this. I would set this to about, you know, zero here, and then adjust this for the forward facings to see how loud I wanted them. And then on the one I'm using as a monitor, I could just turn down a little bit. So, I mean, you're still able to do that, right? So, yes, very cool. Do I recommend it? Absolutely, I recommend it. In just a second, I'll go ahead and hook everything up. And I'll show you the difference with the sub. There's actually not...
I have it set up like I would, say, doing karaoke, okay? So, of course, I would have this turned around or actually even have it to the side facing the singer so they could adjust the levels of their stuff, right? But so here I have, you know, both speakers. Of course, they are in front of the monitor, which faces back. And then the singer, I have the iPad set up right here. And that would be where the singer would stand. Right here, you have the monitor coming in. You're not getting any noise from them because they're forward facing. Okay, now let's go ahead and play something. And I'm gonna play a new song. It's by Collins, and it's called Should I? If you hadn't heard of it, check it out. It's on Amazon and Apple Music and all this other stuff. And anyway, I'm gonna play it, and that way you can hear the difference in, say, now right now, oh, I should say, right now, the monitor is turned all the way down. Okay, so there's not going to be any monitor, and the sub is unplugged. So this, what you're going to hear right now is basically how you would buy the unit. I should also mention that speaker stands do not come with it. You got the speakers and the unit, you got to get your speaker stands. So I'll go ahead and start playing it. I'm going to keep talking as it goes so you can kind of have an idea of how loud it is.
So, just to show you, I'll turn this around so you can see what I'm doing here. Okay, now here we have the monitor, and I'll go ahead and turn it up. See, the monitor can be independently adjusted volume wise and as you could tell, you know, the speaker will get pretty loud, but it sounds nothing like the JBLs. I mean, the JBLs just sound way better.
So
this thing, and now to give you an idea what I'll do here, this isn't really the song to do this with, but I'm gonna use the mic now, okay, and see if you can hear that. I'll even turn the monitor on.
Alright, so now I have the mic on and you can hear.
I can't see her.
So, you can still hear me a little bit over her. I've got 3/4 on the mic. I've also got this turned all the way up.
So if I turn that down like we normally do, then you can get the perfect mix. So yeah, excellent system, especially if you're doing karaoke, you want to set up guitar, you just want to do live performances, excellent. And I've got, of course, reverb on here. I've got about half reverb on. You can turn that off. So that's reverb off, you just zero reverb. And then of course, there's back on. You can adjust the amount. So you can get pretty crazy with it. Or you can get just kind of where it sounds pretty good. Anyway, there you have it. The JBL EON208P, an awesome system for the price. I guess I'll go ahead and pack it up and just let you see what it looks like with both speakers clipped on. Unit, all the stuff that the unit itself comes with will fit in this compartment. Mic, I don't have it in there right now, but the microphone will fit, the power, and then the mic cable, and then also the cables for both the speakers. They fit in there just fine. I've had two mics in there, two mic cables, and then all that stuff, and that fit in there. It's a little, you got to finagle it a little bit, but it does fit. So to put these speakers in, you see those holes in the bottom. You do have to line this up just right. Once you do, okay, then you'll push, sorry, I was going to try to be cool. You push this button, release it, and there it goes. They're on tight. I've read a review where somebody was complaining that they didn't latch very tight and that he lost a speaker. And I honestly don't know how, unless you get a defect. But yeah, I mean, there's play, but you're not going to, it's not going to fall out, right? So now you have the entire unit right here, which is what attracted me to this in the first place. I could have the cables, I could have the mics, everything in this one, you know, carryable unit. Of course, I had to go ahead and add this other stuff too. So now it's no longer that way, but I can still just take this if I want to, if I don't want to mess with the other stuff. However, if you are doing karaoke or you're singing, you're performing, a monitor is, wow, it's worth its weight in gold because, you know, you really need to hear yourself so you don't sound like the operator and just totally off key. So there it is. JBL EON208P. Highly recommend it. Excellent, excellent, excellent little PA system for the price. And the Behringer, I guess I ought to tell you what one that is, right? The one I got. You probably saw it on the back. Behringer EUROLIVE B1200D-Pro, the 12-inch PA subwoofer. It is active, it's powered. And then the ALTO is the TX208. It's the 8-inch loudspeaker. And I mean, a great, great, great pair for those things. Excellent, excellent. You don't need a new mic. By any means, the mic that it comes with works great. There you have it. Hope you enjoyed this.